I'm sorry that I don't speak Russian very well, but I'm still trying to get used to my amp, so I'm just going to warm up a little bit. You guys can check it out.
Thank you.
to one of the backing tracks, and then I'll answer some questions and I'll take it from there.
Сейчас немножко поиграю, потом вроде. Thank you.
I really appreciate it. Thank you so much. And thank you to Alex and his company and ESP. And just great to be here. Thank you very much. Say whatever you want to say to me. The thing that I want to talk about a little bit is just a couple of concepts that I use for playing fast, mostly. And the first thing is, a lot of you probably noticed that I use my first finger to sort of clamp down on two or more strings.
Очень много, и о которых его постоянно спрашивают разные гитаристы. Но первое, на чем он хочет остановиться, это, может быть, многим обратить внимание, что он очень много употребляет свой указательный палец, который зажимает две или три струны. Ну, в общем, это прием для быстрой игры, как бы, продолжим тему.
And, oh yeah, originally I had handout sheets that we weren't able to make copies of, but maybe whoever comes to the signing tomorrow, I can have them ready by then. I apologize. So here's one of the things that the first thing that I could ever probably play on the guitar that was impressed my friends was just a concept that goes like this. So I'm playing an upstroke and a downstroke on two separate strings, and a pull off, and that leads to a lot of other licks that. A lot of the concepts that I end up using in my playing all the time. So I'll just play real slow, and then you can see how easy it is to play really fast. It's a basic lick, and then I got comfortable with that and started using another finger to bar as well. Another finger to do the same thing. So I don't know if you want to say that.
Первое, что поражало очень многих коллег Грега, когда он только начинал играть, это вот такой прием, когда он зажимает вот указательным пальцем вторым две струны и употребляет один удар вниз, затем пальцем, затем вверх, и ну, вы видели прием.
It's almost like you want it to sound like a two-handed lick. So you want it to sound like Very smooth. So the next thing I stumbled across was playing arpeggios, doing the same exact technique, because I noticed a lot of guitar players would use. So I use that technique to play.
Но следующим этапом было переложение. Применение этого приема к известному приему, который многие гитаристы играют, честно показал, да, там, когда пальцы вот так стоят. То есть с помощью вот зажима одним пальцем указать.
He could be saying anything right now. So that's just some of the concepts. The other concept, and that led to some cool things. Anybody who ever wants to get into it, if I took that shape, move it an octave lower, I was just able to get a lot of cool stuff. Like, I didn't say that. So I'll talk a little bit more about some boring stuff of mine, and then I'll play to another song. Well, actually, we'll take the questions first. The other thing that I do that's weird that people ask me about all the time is doing hammer-ons to strings that were not previously fretted.
Вот еще один прием, о котором постоянно спрашивают, это вот hammer-on, ну известный, да, гитарный прием. Я правильно сказал?
I use my second finger a lot on my right hand for up-picks, up-strokes.
И он напрягает третий палец для ударов снизу.
Combining that with the previous idea of barn, you can play.
Да, он соединил вот два приема, первый и второй вместе, потому что мы можем это сделать.
Sure. Questions. I'm playing the original example for the hammer-ons from Nowhere was I'm just playing a chord shape, in this case A major. And I'm playing an upstroke on the B string, a downstroke on the G string, and then hammering with my third finger. It's pretty easy, it just feels uncomfortable at first. You can change the shape to whatever you want. I'm not really that good, so. And there's a lot of shapes. I was using an open string. Actually, it almost sounds like finger picking, so you can pretend that you. I can't finger pick very well, so when people ask if I can finger pick, that's what I usually do.
And they believe me. Очень трудно делать, когда вас спрашивают о том, что я медленнее.
So I'll take some questions now if you guys want to.
Вопросы есть? Про что? Какой вот это? Can you explain why you have this rubber thing?
Tell him that I was hoping he didn't notice it. But I will explain.
Ну, может, никто не заметит. Сейчас объясню.
It's for two-handed licks. I saw Jason Becker do it back in when I was recording for Shrapnel Records. And it just helps keep some of the strings quiet, especially for two-handed licks. But I do a lot of the. Keeps it quiet if it, otherwise it sounds sloppy. If it. It's not too different.
No, перенял этот прием у Джейсон Бек.
Джейсон Бек.
Да. Перенял. И это помогает при определенных при такой технике игры помогает немножко играть потише, потому что значит все так звенит, как он сказал.
Still sloppy. I've always done that. I don't know where that. No, I've always done that. I don't know why. I don't know where that came from. But all it is really just sliding like that. But there's a way. It's hard for people to do it sometimes because if you don't do it, you know, just right, it sounds like it's got to sound like the original note. I don't know exactly, but that's all I'm doing is just sliding.
Your strings are very low, right?
Yeah, they're pretty low.
What? Why do you do that?
Because it's easy. Picks. I'm still not sure what I like.
Он еще до сих пор пока не уверен, вообще каким медиатором он любит больше всего.
It changes every day. Sometimes
it's medium,
sometimes medium, sometimes heavy.
Иногда средний, иногда более жесткий.
Yeah, strings are always D'Addario 10 gauge strings.
String D'Addario 10.
D'Addario fans, yeah.
He plays soul from 1989. I don't know which one.
I don't know. I don't know what I, they're all my solos sound the same, so anything I play should sound like that.
Все соло одинаковые, поэтому какая разница?
I can just play, you know, but...
Just play!
Are you gonna release a new video lessons?
Yes. I'm working on those right now, and I'm hoping.
Да, сейчас работает над этим.
Yeah, I think.
So when the release gonna?
I'm hoping by the middle of the summer.
Середине лета.
We're done. There's gonna be different versions. There's gonna be one on just technique, and one on improvisation probably.
Будут разные версии. Одна по поводу техники, другая школа по поводу импровизации.
Yeah.
They want you to play.
Just play again. Same licks over and over. We'll be right back. also playing a half step above the key and coming back to it. That's what Larry Carlton does it a lot.
Потом, например, такой правильный прием, он уходит на полтона выше тона, затем возвращается обратно.
Yeah, and it just goes like... It doesn't sound as good when you don't have music, you know, so...
Ну, без музыки это так невозможно.
А?
What else inspires you besides music?
Definitely, anything, you know, places, you know, just if I'm in a certain place that, you know, I can be inspired. A movie can inspire me. Obviously, you know, beautiful women, that's a big inspiration sometimes, so. But a lot of times it's just hearing a groove. A lot of times I'll hear like a pop song, and it will give me an idea for an instrumental song, even something. I listen to a lot of mainstream music that's not instrumental at all, or not even complicated, and I get probably more ideas from that than I do, you know, listening to like Alan Holdsworth or something. I'd almost rather listen to watch MTV all day and try to hear some kind of cool groove or something and use it, try to make a more intellectual version of that idea.
Ну, Грегор добавляет самые разные вещи, какие-то места, в которых он не бывал, кинофильмы, естественно, красивые женщины, как всякого нормального человека. И потом он может найти вдохновение в самых неожиданных вещах, как, допустим, он привел пример, что он слушает какую-то поп-песню, и там неожиданно какой-то хороший грув, и это может стать идеей для какой-то его новой композиции, несомненно, на более интеллектуальном, высоком интеллектуальном уровне, чем он слушает.
The barring technique, and then using the hammer-on from nowhere.
Вот он привел такую комбинацию вот этой техники барес с хаммерингом там на нижней струне.
Right, so I can't pick very well, so these hammer-ons help me out when it comes to big intervals if I want to play. Even if, like, I practice taking a triad. Yeah, and just playing low notes that are diatonic to it, or you know, whatever comes to mind. So it's really a lot of the same stuff. A lot of it's based on barring. Partly arpeggios. The arpeggio gives the color, you know, for it. But then instead of just playing a straight arpeggio, I'll try to make it interesting by adding some diatonic notes in, you know, on certain strings.
И затем не просто играет арпеджио, там, если хочет это сделать какой-нибудь интереснее, употребляет диатонические ноты еще между.
The two-handed quiet interval stuff is a lot of it's based on hammering with the left hand first, again, so it's like hammer on.
Двухручная игра в значительной степени базируется на опять же, на хэмминг.
Yeah, with the left hand, and then. Cool, but it's really easy, so.
Звучит здорово, а на самом деле довольно просто.
I slow version, but it's all based on... Yeah, most of the two-handed stuff that I do is based on the left hand hitting the strings first, which is different than...
В основном все это базируется на том, что левая рука сначала ударяет левая рука, потом уже правая.
Right,
so it's a
combination. You guys are way too nice.
How about blues?
Yeah. How about it? I pretty much play standard, you know, the same licks that most people play. Favorite note.
Ну, в принципе, Грег сказал, что он играет все стандарты, эти, которые играют весь мир.
Like who? Who is that? No, I really can't. I can't play like that. I'm not good at it. I can fake, you know, there's the double stop stuff. You know. But he has his own sound, and you know, no, I've never heard anybody really sound like that. You know, it's great. Yeah, I can do this though. That's as close as it
goes. В большинстве случаев он не использует, естественно, полные аккорды, это как частичные. Ну, на добрый
вопрос. I didn't know I was back then. I don't know. It depends. Sometimes trying to think of a good example. A lot of times rhythm is really just a couple of notes. A lot of my rhythms are just like, you know.
Но порой ритм это просто пару нот.
Kind of use the same techniques in a lot of rhythms that I do otherwise. Some of the generic funk, you know.
Такой базовый фанк группчик.
I don't mean nothing special about my rhythm playing. It's just,
ничего особенного. Правда, он сказал, что он употребляет ту же самую технику, которую он показывал, и в аккомпанементе.
Have you ever transcribed your solo?
No.
Нет.
I can't. People like that do it for me. And then I call them and ask for it so I can relearn it myself.
Не просите его, чтобы он сам себя выучил.
Yeah, when he gets done with my song, I'd like him to send it to me so I can.
Он хочет, чтобы ты, когда снимешь соло, прислал ему.
Yeah, I'm gonna play just to the solo section of the first song of my last album. I just have the solo section looped over and over again. It's you can hear it and just comment on it.
Сольный эпизод с песни со своего последнего альбома.
называется он?
That